Today's video is about a scientist. Wait, no, before you click away from the video, because scientists are boring and all they do is calculate, this is not your everyday scientist. This is Tycho Brahe, and his story includes a pet moose, a psychic jester, and a lot of alcohol. Tycho was the first astronomer to correctly define supernova, disputing the theory that dates back all the way to Aristotle, which says that everything behind the moon is eternally unchangeable. His measurements were far more precise than any of his contemporaries, which is even more admirable when we take into consideration that the telescope didn't even exist in the 16th century. His personal life was unconventional, to say the least, and his pretty bizarre story begins with him as a baby. At the age of 2, Tycho was only one of 12 children to live with his uncle and not his family. His uncle Jorgen was said to have kidnapped him from his brother, who went back on his promise to give the baby to him. However, many people dispute this to be true and say that his father sent him to his uncle, probably because he had already started drinking and telling rude jokes in front of his mom. When he turned 15, Tycho was sent on a Euro trip to study law. But as astronomy was his passion, he enrolled in Leipzig University, where he observed the planets and found faults in Copernican tables. This inspired him greatly to pursue his passion for astronomy, and he gave up on his uncle's wishes to become a civil servant. During this time, Denmark was in war with Sweden, and his uncle became a national hero. He died of pneumonia, which he contracted when he jumped in the river to save the king, who was drunk and fell in. At this point, Tycho inherited his uncle Jorgen's wealth and land, and even without this, he was an heir to his mom and dad's families, which were noble and incredibly rich. Tycho also counted 4 other noble families as his ancestors, and at the time owned 1% of all the money in Denmark. And of course, like any sane scientist would, he used this money for research and for alcohol. When Tycho was 20, he attended a wedding dance in Germany. Obviously, he got drunk and got into a fight with his cousin. They had a typical drunk fight over a mathematical formula, so Tycho decided to Google the right answer. Since the internet didn't exist, that solution failed, so they chose the only alternative at the time, a duel in the dark. Tycho arrived drunk to the duel and lost his nose in the course of the fight. From that point on, he wore a fake nose supposedly made out of gold, which he would glue to his face with paste. Tycho wanted to move to Basel to continue with his work, but when the king heard about this, he didn't want to lose such a great scientist and offered Tycho the island of Hven and also paid for the construction of his own observatory. Until then, Hven was occupied by around 50 farmer families. When Tycho came, he made himself an absolute ruler, made all the decisions without consulting anyone, and made the residents work unpaid on building his new castle. He also demanded for them to cultivate twice as much as before, and made a system of ponds so that the farmers could work in a paper mill. Because, you know, Tycho's books required paper. The farmers decided to sue Tycho, and they won. The court made Tycho sign contracts with the residents, in which the terms didn't really change, except that now they had it in writing. Tycho's time on Hven was marked by almost daily parties and excessive drinking. He had a little person on as a jester, which Tycho thought was psychic and could predict the future. Psychic or not, the jester was forced to eat his dinner under the table and to insult the guests, all for Tycho's amusement. He also held a tamed moose in his castle as a pet. As Tycho was enjoying drinking too much, he saw nothing wrong with making the moose drink lots of beer and be drunk every night. One time, his friend asked him to send the moose to his castle for a party, and the moose came without Tycho. It drank beer and got very drunk, and when it tried to climb down the stairs, it fell to its death. The king also died, and that meant the end of Tycho's Hven haven. The new juvenile king was against him thanks to his advisors, who hated Tycho. He also wasn't particularly happy about the rumors that Tycho was having an affair with the king's mother. He went into exile and arrived in Prague on the Bohemian king's invitation. There, Johannes Kepler became his assistant. Kepler later went on to become one of the most important scientists of the 17th century. He spent his last 4 years in Prague, where he worked on trying to prove that Copernican's studies were wrong. He was correct in thinking that the moon orbits around the Earth and that the planets orbit around the Sun. However, he also thought that the Sun orbits around the Earth. During his entire life, Tycho also focused on astrology and alchemy. He wanted to discover a medicine which would cure every single disease and mixed astrology with astronomy to make future predictions. For example, he predicted that Ivan the Terrible would die in 1583. He died a year later. In 1601, he attended a banquet. As you would expect, he started drinking heavily and had to pee. However, he refused to do it because it was against the etiquette to leave the table before the host. This resulted in a burst bladder and he died 11 days later. In his last days, feeling what was about to come, Tycho wrote his own epitaph. He lived like a sage and died like a fool.
Be sure to like and share the video if you enjoyed it, and don't forget to subscribe. See you next week!